My name is Yanai Kashtan. I'm from Oakland, and right now I'm a rising senior. My research this summer is, the kind of jargony title is Analyzing Charge Carrier Transport in Organic Field Effect Transistors. And basically what that means is we're looking at trying to understand how charges move through a new type of material so that we can make more efficient devices out of this material in the future. I will say, so I'm probably not the kind of prototypical liberal arts student here at Pomona in that I'm taking mostly physics and chemistry, but what I really love about Pomona and why I chose to come here rather than to go, say, to, you know, a Harvey Mudd or some more technical type of STEM school is that I get to interact with people who are doing something completely different. Homeschooling, I kind of constructed a little chemistry lab in my garage, and I was really into chemistry, not as much physics. And I think the reason for that was because as somebody building something in the garage, chemistry is much more accessible. Physics, the pieces of equipment that you need to even do basic stuff are just much more expensive, so it was less accessible to me. But when I got to Pomona, I realized I really like physics, maybe even more than chemistry. And so I'm also majoring in chemistry because I still love chemistry, but I've been sort of gradually transitioning over to physics. What I really enjoy about being a physics and chemistry double major is that it allows me to look at scientific problems from two different angles and really have a good grounding in these two different disciplines, which are related but quite different. The downside is the course requirements for doing the two majors are large enough that I don't have a ton of time to do courses outside of those majors, especially since I'm also having to take a lot of math. My week generally has classes in the morning in the classroom, and then typically three, sometimes four labs per week in the afternoon, and then I do my homework in the evenings or on the weekends. And sometimes I try to have a weekend free where I can go off into the mountains and go hiking. Usually, I spend a lot of my time in Millikan, which is the physics building. It's a really nice new building, and it's a really nice space to study and to both do homework and to do research, because that's where all of the physics labs are. Now, what's nice is my schedule is starting to open up a little bit in the summer. I'm doing 40 hours a week of research, but I've got evenings and weekends to spend. I've been doing an independent study, so that's been taking up a lot of my time, but now I'm going to be getting into the mountains some more, doing hiking and trail running and some mountaineering, which is really what I love to do kind of on my free time. So I'm enjoying this slightly more relaxed pace in the summer. I've been going up to the Sierras, to the Southern Sierras, Scotty, Owens, Olancha, and trying to aim for some of the 14ers now that the snow is melting. My workflow is pretty variable day to day. If I'm making these devices, these transistors, then it's a pretty intense period. So I'll start 8 p.m. one day, start the prep, end at about 10:30, and the next morning at about 6:30 a.m. come back in and finish the prep, and then characterize these devices with this imaging technique throughout the whole day. Over the summer, it's a pretty different pace than the school year. There are many fewer students on campus, it's a lot quieter, but there are still some things going on. So in physics, for example, where there's a lot of research, you know, lab research to be done where you have to be on campus to do it, there are plenty of students still here. In my lab with Professor Hudgings, there are three other students who are here doing research. And sometimes we're in lab together. We're all working on our respective projects, but it's a very friendly, convivial atmosphere. And even though we're working hard, you know, there is company, there is, you know, somebody to go walk to the village with, etc. And also in this interim, it's an opportunity to cook for yourself, to go out in the village and eat. Professors are typically around and much more available to your questions and concerns than during the school year when their attention is divided between you and many more other students. So one thing that I would say that was sort of the hardest stumbling block for me first getting into research was the realization that when you're in a class and you read about some law or some equation, some phenomenon that was discovered, and you read in a couple of paragraphs and you have a couple of questions on homework where you have to use that concept, that was probably one or many people's lifetimes of work. and you're just zooming by it at, you know, 100 miles an hour in a course when you're learning it. And so to go from that kind of mindset where you're just absorbing information that other people have already generated, all nicely chunked for you in a textbook, but you're the person generating that knowledge, and that's a really special feeling. You also just have to become accustomed to frustration and things not working out and feeling like you're putting all this effort in and getting nothing back for a while, until you do. That's helped me be more confident that I want to go to grad school, and it's also helped me narrow down within grad school, which is, you know, you could study anything under physics, to know that I really want to be an experimentalist and that I want to be doing experiments at the interface of physics and chemistry. I've become pretty clear that I want to do research that's has something to do with both physics and chemistry, that's experimental, and that has a broader purpose. And in particular, it seems like with my scientific skill set, that broader purpose can be fighting climate change, and that would be a very useful use of my skill set. I'm very happy with my choice of Pomona. I think that I made the right choice to come here, of all the places to go.